As a scientist, for me, it's important for my faith. What I learn when I do my research and understand nature helps me build my faith and to just see how big and how wonderful gold is. But at the same time, the things that I learn, I can use and actually refer to them to share with Christians and to help other people turn to the Christian faith by sharing little stories about how nature behaves and how that can be inferred to us as human beings.
If we're meant to be progressive, progressive means not leaving anyone behind. At the moment, we are guilty of leaving so many of us behind. And that's not excellence as a human race. I think we're capable. We have more resources now, more intelligence, more knowledge, as it were, more research, as a matter of fact, that should enable to say, let's deal with the basics. Water, food, medicine, health, these should no longer be challenges. Education for our children should no longer be challenges we can deal with. While we attempt for the higher ideals, let's address this. So I'm looking for that kind of world where we go back to say, what does progress really mean? Progress means all of us, not just some of us.
I think the big challenge facing us is how large these problems seem. Earth care, how can I as a person make a difference when everything seems so insurmountable? And I think the way forward is to look at our problems in a smaller area. And an obvious one from my water background is a catchment area or a basin or a watershed, as you call it in America. Every church, every university, every house is actually physically within a catchment. And that's a smaller bounded area that can be used to help me engage with issues of social justice, economic justice, environmental justice. If there's an intervention, it can be my place in this catchment rather than trying to make a difference to the whole city or the whole world.
In my country, we have a love bird, small bird. It's a parrot species that is a cavity dweller. Now, in Malawi, we do not have big woodpeckers that would, knock holes into trees. So you'll find that this bird is found in a woodland we call Mopani Woodland. And we asked, why is this bird here? And you find Mopani Woodland is one of the few trees in Africa that form cavities naturally. So this bird now does not need to make its own cavity. The cavity is there. It uses these particular trees to nest, to roost in, because they have these natural cavities. And so God made sure that this tree is in this place for this bird to be able to use it.
But conservation globally, whether it's people of faith or not, recognize that this is in some sense a human problem. It's not a problem of data, it's not a problem of science, it's a human problem. It's our impact on the rest of the world that is changing the world about us so rapidly.